Think about what the sister's saying.
Sorry, I was muted. I've never been in a public relationship, but she sounds pretty strong. It sounds like the relationship is very, very healthy. She sounds very, very happy, very fulfilled. And I agree with her. You know, there's a saying that it takes a village to raise a child. And so, you know, I'm beginning to understand why it's important for a man to have more than one woman. I really do. I'm beginning to see why it's important, because it's just I just see a lot of things that our women do and how we behave and how we get sometimes. And, you know, it's like, you know, some of these our sisters, they have these really, really good men, and they, the way they treat, they don't appreciate and respect them. And then when a man finally puts them away, then they keep calling back and crying back, trying to come back. They had a good thing and they blanked it up. And God, and I mean, you can't put up with so much. I mean, it's like the Most High, you know. I mean, there are times we've had to give Israel a bill of divorce. He had to send us into captivity to bring us back to him. And I believe it's good that these men put these women away so that these women can really begin to understand what good thing they had when they had these good men. Because it's like you said, the women outnumber the men. And you finally get a good man, and you don't know how to appreciate him and respect him. And then you get upset when he go get other women, you get bothered, you get all in your feelings and all emotion. But now that I've been learning and hearing about this, you know, these polygamous relationships, I'm beginning to understand it. It's beginning to make sense to me. It really is. Before it didn't, I used to say all that kind of stuff. I'd rather be alone. I don't want to be alone. I don't need to be alone. I'm a woman. I don't have any children. Grandchild. I've never had any children, but I don't like it. I don't want to be alone.
Crystal.
You need
so to one of the good things about what I've learned about polygamy for the time that I practice it,
yeah,
is one wife actually keeps the other wife in line, because it makes her like there's certain things a woman she's not gonna do in the face of another woman, right? Because she's like, yo, that's off, you know, but. When the other woman's not around, you know, she's like more combative. You understand what I'm saying? So from that sense, when she knows there's other eyes on her, like judging her, it's like kind of like a stage play. It becomes an act. Right? So she'll act a particular way. Right? So, and because you know why? It's dealing with, that's not operating from the rule. It's operating from a place of envy and jealousy. So it's not that she wants to please her husband, but she wants to be competitive.